by that gray area lot as well. When you first wake up, when you don't really, you know, when you're a little half asleep, a little half awake, when everything in the world is like tranquil and perfect and it's fine and there's no issues and there's no bills and there's no nothing.
Yeah, man. You know?
I have three kids under six. I have no idea what the hell you're talking about. I'm sitting over here shaking my head and I'm like, what the fuck is he talking about?
That's the worst
part of my day, every day of my life.
You do have that little gray area time. The only thing is that yours is like lightning quick.
Yeah, right. 15 minutes. From six when I actually wake up to when the baby wakes up around 6:15.
Yeah, right. For you, it's like milliseconds before you realize what's going on.
Go ahead.
What the hell's going on in your life? Yeah. So I go to, put that post up on Facebook, and for some reason, usually I will, like, if I'm going to do something with a picture, and this is stupid, but it all falls together. Usually I'll just write all the caption and I'll put the picture in afterwards. I put the picture in first.
Right.
Which is odd. Right. So I'm looking at this and I type in 7 years ago, I used to, you know, I lived in this garden apartment, blah, 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 because I was laying in bed in the new house. This is already New Year's Eve.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, my God, 7 years. Hmm. Right?
Right.
So then that whole day I spent, like, it was a very hard day because I did a tremendous amount of self-reflection, one day. And through that, you know how the way our lives are and the way our brains are, I mean, we're just going to shut off as much of the bad shit as we possibly can.
Absolutely.
You know? And then I realized that it took me 7 years to basically turn everything around and get myself to the point of where I really wanted to be the day that I moved into that apartment 7 years prior. It took me 7 years to put all of the things back and to put them back in a way better than they were before.
Right.
So then I started to reverse engineer what I actually did, like how I broke things down. And I would look at my own organic behavior through the way that I would set goals and the way that I would measure those goals, the way I would set up my day, the way I would set up a week, the way I would set up every moment. That we're just, you know, that we're just sitting here, whatever it is that we're going through, I would reverse engineer that all the way back. And that's basically what I did all day, New Year's Day.
And when you say write, are you talking about you're writing it down or
every behavior that goes along with it. I'm very big on writing things by hand. I think that when you write things by hand,
it's almost like you're
scraping them into
my notebook with me.
It's a commitment.
It's a commitment part. You're scraping it in. It helps you to remember much better than if you just text. There's something with the handwriting and, you know, so a lot of, and this is a thing that a lot of people like, this is why there isn't a really good app planner that exists.
Yeah, there is.
There really isn't a good one. There isn't one that everybody like flocks to or everybody uses because they all suck because you're not writing with your hand.
So
a lot of it doesn't have meaning. A lot of it doesn't have any type of stickiness to it whatsoever. It just,
good
point. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's no real impact in it.
Right. So go ahead. I'm sorry.
So then New Year's Day, I spent even more time just rewinding and rewinding. And I realized that I had used what became the rule of seven. I had used it twice because from, you know, back in 1994, you know, I was a broken down, beat up, you know, had two kids and living on a shoestring, you know, and I had decided that I didn't want to be a schnook anymore. That I wasn't going to live my life like that, paycheck to paycheck, you know, hand to mouth, waiting for your fucking income tax return to come so that you could, you know, do something stupid with it, like go to Wildwood or some shit like that, you know?
Yeah.
Which I did in 1994, which I shouldn't have done.
I hear you. I can relate. There's like a lot of people going, oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Right now.
And I used that exact same formula. The thing is, from 94 forward, I used that same formula, but I did it just organically. I just did it through my own actions and everything. I didn't realize that was the way I was setting things up.
Right.
But in 2010, 2011, it was totally like, you know, like I designed that stuff. Like that's the way that I was working it. I just didn't have it into any type of like a structure or anything to where I could teach you or teach you or somebody could read it and follow the exact same thing.
Right.
And what it boils down to is it's all reverse engineering in time frames that are all seven. And if anybody wants to, I won't bore everybody with it, but if you want to do any research on the number seven, there's a reason that it works. Hmm. You know, and it's basically, it's a divine number. It's sure. non-divisible. There's all these types of things about the number seven that have so much, you know, so much power
they do.
behind them.
For thousands of years.
Yeah, exactly. So this isn't, you know, putting it into a structure. Yeah, that's mine. But the fact right. that the number seven is right. what it is has nothing to do with me. I just tapped into it, you
right.
know,
right.
I just tapped into it and used it.